All right. Welcome back to the Sheldon McLeod Show on News 95.7. Matt Brand, our producer. Survivors of suicide loss are under-supported. November 17 marks Survivors of Suicide Loss Day. And here with us on the broadcast is a clinical psychologist, a professor in the Department of Psychology and Neuroscience at Dalhousie. Dr. Simon Sherry, welcome back to the program.
Welcome, Sheldon. I'm glad we're talking today.
And again, these are tough conversations. These are difficult conversations to have. Why do you feel that the province is not doing enough to prevent suicide and its devastating impacts?
Our provincial suicide prevention strategy is decades out of date. And when it comes to helping people in the aftermath of suicide, there's very little support, if any, available for Nova Scotians, even though we know that after a suicide, there are often very serious, very negative consequences.
You've put this to some, you put some statistics in the news release about this, and I saw an infographic, and the context of that was, we're in a crisis. Would you describe it as a crisis?
I would absolutely describe the problems we're having with suicide in our province as a crisis, and there are the numbers present to back it up. For example, between 2000 and 2012, our suicide rate has gone up faster than any other province in Canada. If you look back in 2000, we had roughly 75 suicides in Nova Scotia. By 2016, that number of suicides had gone up to 134, so that's more than a 40% increase. Keep in mind that Nova Scotia's population has increased very little, if at all, during that time period. And the crisis isn't just about those who were sadly losing from suicide. It's also about those who are left behind, survivors of suicide loss.
And most times when I hear from people or people become part of the news cycle, it's about the survivors who say that their family members have fallen through the cracks. Is that a sign that perhaps the follow-up, that the support isn't there?
I think that people are absolutely falling through the cracks in our province in several ways. First of all, vulnerable people are not receiving the help they need in order to prevent suicide. And then after suicide happens, we're not doing the things we need to do to help and to support people to recover. For example, there is tremendous grief and distress in the wake of suicide. A suicide is a different sort of death. It's often shocking, it's unexpected, and it can often occur in undignified ways. And not surprisingly, it is traumatic for friends, family, and loved ones. There are stigma surrounding it, there's shame, guilt, even blame can be present. You can feel very rejected or very abandoned by the loved one. Maybe sometimes you feel responsible, and anger and really complicated forms of grief can often follow. And when I speak about this, Sheldon, I speak about it as a practicing clinical psychologist. These are problems and challenges I've witnessed over the last decade as I've worked in this province, often helping people with suicide and survivors of suicide loss.
Dr. Simon Sherry, a clinical psychologist, professor in the Department of Psychology and Neuroscience at Dalhousie University, is our guest. This Saturday marks Survivors of Suicide Loss Day. We've had a guest on our program in the past who says that it's not necessarily that we don't have enough resources, it's that those resources are not allocated in a way that puts the patient first. That, you know, wait lines or having, you know, showing up at an emergency room in crisis and being told, you're fine, go home. Those types of scenarios that we hear of often. But we don't hear the response from the professionals in that role. They're not allowed, for the most part, to talk about it because of privacy issues. So is there a disconnect between what's really going on and the perception that people are not getting the adequate supports?
I think what's really going on is that our government isn't leading and coordinating a suicide prevention strategy. We're not putting the funds and the resources in place to have an effective system that prevents suicide in our province and supports people in the aftermath. Certainly, we can always try and make more efficient use of resources. At the same time, in provinces like Quebec, when the provincial government has dedicated resources to suicide prevention, there have been real and rapid observable results. And keep in mind, I tend to look at this from a compassionate standpoint and looking after our most vulnerable citizens. But even if you want to make a cold economic argument, suicide is enormously expensive in our province. Out-of-date, decade-old estimates have it that suicide and associated behaviors cost our province about $55 million per year. So this is a very expensive problem for Nova Scotians.
You say a lack of leadership, it's difficult to solve a problem if you first don't acknowledge there is a problem.
We have had a partial acknowledgement from Mr. McNeil, our Premier, on the 26th of September. He made some somewhat vague reference to a suicide prevention strategy starting to be implemented in our province. He was also elected in 2013, and he's had more than 5 years to work on this. And during the period of his governance, our suicide crisis has only gotten worse.
Again, our guest is Dr. Simon Sherry. So November 17th, Survivors of Suicide Loss Day, there will be people who will be getting together to talk to, in some ways, grieve together. I'm going to leave this name out, but someone I know whose son has been struggling with mental health issues and mental health challenges now for almost 25 years, and recently was in a point where he's feeling suicidal. What is it, if you could give us some advice, Dr. Sherry, what should we know about dealing with someone who presents that way?
I won't speak to that particular example, but in general, it's a very relevant question. And what I would want our government to appreciate is that suicide is very preventable. Suicide is seldom a single event. There's often a process that can involve many years leading up to suicide. It includes suicidal thoughts, suicidal threats, often attempts at suicide. There are many opportunities for us to intervene. And at this point, we have a fairly well-developed science that would assist us in helping people who are suicidal by, for example, connecting them to needed interventions or needed medications, by removing from their environment the means with which they may engage in suicide behavior. There are all sorts of ways that we can definitely help people at this point.
Well, Doctor, we'll leave it at that for today. I mean, it's an important conversation that's not, at the very least, we scratched the surface, but it's not over by any means. We'll keep this conversation going. Thank you for being a part of our show.
Thank you for drawing attention to what is a very important issue for all Nova Scotians. I don't think that suicide is any one person's responsibility. It's our responsibility.
Dr. Simon Sherry, a professor in Dalhousie's Department of Psychology and Neurology, or Neuroscience. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Dr. Simon Sherry here with us today. Evening of Hope for Survivors of Suicide Day. This is happening tomorrow at 7 o'clock at St. Mary's University, the Atrium Building. It's in room AT340. It's a free event. Donations are being accepted for that. And it is presented by the Halifax Walk for World Suicide Prevention Day. And thank you, Laurel Walker, for posting that earlier in the week.